Don't pick me up before I fall. And like a tango, it takes two. I don't want you thinking that I put it all on you. I let it happen. I know that now. But if you still wanna be my hero, let me tell you how. Don't pick me up before I fall. That kind of help, it's just no help at all. You keep trying to save me when there's no call. Don't pick me up before I fall. We have we? I love the use of the we, the couple we. It's not like the royal we. It's not like the New Yorker magazine we. It's the, we love that movie, we. So we took in a rescue dog, even though I was not at home. And it bit Kathy a number of times because he was a very troubled dog, and she wouldn't give up on him. She just wouldn't give up on him. It was a testament to her character. And so I was in Denmark, and I was supposed to write with this guy named Peter Busborg, and he's a very, very funny guy with a very dry sense of humor. And I said, you know, I have this idea about the song I want to write. I don't really want to write a song about a woman and a dog, but I would like to write a song about this idea that I think is bigger than that, or, you know, not to minimize that at all, but, you know, just that I think is more universal, which is that, you know, she won't give up on love, and I think that applies. There's a lot of people like that in one way or another. No matter how tough it gets there, they hang in there. So he sits there for a long moment, and he goes, all right, to see if I will understand. You are traveling, as you are now, and your lovely bride took in a troubled creature to try to improve his life. Yeah, that's what happened. And despite her boundless love and affection, he continues to be a troubled wretch and has bitten her on many occasions. At this point, 20 or 30 times, am I exaggerating? No? Yeah, that's pretty much what's happened. And even though this creature that she, with all good intention, took him into her home, with all this biting, she persists. I said, yeah. Is it possible, Craig, that you yourself benefit from this trait in her personality? Shut up. So as we do when we're songwriters, we stole a plot from another thing that was going on with some friends and stuck that into the verses. So go ahead and figure out what the song's about. Maybe this is the long goodbye. Maybe it ends this way. But when did their perfect life turn into the sad cliche? Living in a cold house, all the fire's gone. Feels like she's fighting for a lost cause, so she's gotta hang on. She won't give up on love. That's not what she does. When the road gets rough, she's the owner of a heart both true and tough. She won't give up on love. There must be something that she can say, something that she can do. But now it's so far away, never seems to get through. She's so tired of living in limbo. Well, she hopes it gets out. But if there's a chance that they could still work it out, she's not gonna let go. Cause she won't give up on love. That's not what she does. Amazing conglomeration of geography there. And one of the young women who was at this writer's retreat was there from her sort of magnet high school. She was 17. And the rest of us were there doing a collaborative. It was a workshop for co-writing to get together and write with people from different parts of the world and different approaches and see what the collaboration would bring. But she was taking walks in the woods and writing by herself the entire week. And I remember asking one time the people who were running the thing, I said, so what's up with Madeline? She's always just off in the woods. She's collaborating with nature. Okay, is she from Eugene? Because, I'm from Oregon, so I'm hip to this whole, she's collaborating with nature, okay. A couple years later, she married music. That's another story. But about 3 days in, they came to me and they said, Madeline has expressed interest in writing a song with you if you're interested. And I said, well, that's fascinating. I thought she wasn't here doing any collaborating. Well, she's not, but she, when she's been here a few days and sees what's going on, she thought that it would be the easiest for the two of you to write together since you would have the absolute least in common. Okay.
Like, for example,
she's the youngest writer here, and I said, hey, there's a 74-year-old sculptor here from Norway. I am not the oldest writer here. And the guy goes, all right, the second oldest. It's like with just a poker face. He goes, ha ha ha. You guys are funny. And I said, well, what did she say about it? And he said, 17, bear this in mind. She said, well, if two people who are both experts with making the omelet get sent to the kitchen to make the lunch, no one eats. Wow! I like to buy her book. Like, wow! And she said, but if one person will just make a salad and the other will just make sandwiches and there is nobody, it's their territory. then there will, you'll just, you know, everyone gets to have lunch. So I feel like what Craig does and what I do, they don't have any, we can't possibly argue, but they're so unrelated. We wrote this song in 15 minutes. She was completely right. How utterly bizarre. So she's got what's called synesthesia, where she hears a musical tone and she sees a color. And so I went, and she went, I said, what? And she said, well, it's like a brown I would like to not talk about. Oh, man. Oh, please, can we talk about it? That's so good. But no. So I went, well, what about? And she goes, oh, I can smell the mint. We are by the water. Works for me. Her name is Madeline Jonsson. She is a very unusual Scandinavian artist. I was lucky enough to get her to sing on this song that we wrote together on my record, The Vagabond. Take a step, mind the fog. Come out to the ledge. Never mind all the rest. They don't know us now. Quietly, couldn't we dance before the moon? No one has to know the tune. Hoping you breathe in deep. Secrets in you, hanging high oak branches, wildly grasping me. Resting head in hand with you. Little things carrying messages of grace. Little things carrying messages of grace. Treetop song wandering, I can't sing along. Shivering up till now, do you know I'm here? Quietly, couldn't we dance before the moon? Dance before the moon. No one has to know the tune. And it happens every night, though it's just a trick of light. When the moon shines in just right, it looks like you. It looks like you. It looks like you. Looks like you made your mind up, you're not coming back. Looks like me and my jealous heart, we made sure that. Now the face of the cold hard truth, it looks like you. My heart still races in all our old familiar places. Every time I see your face, it looks like you. It's a habit I can't break. Every time I double take, but it's just one more mistake that looks like you. It looks like you. It looks like you. Looks like you made your mind up, you're not coming back. Looks like me and my jealous heart, we made sure of that. Now the face of the cold hard truth, well, it looks like you. Well, someday I'll be free, but until that day I'll be clinging to this memory. It looks like you. Looks like you made your mind up, you're not coming back. Looks like me and my jealous heart, we made sure of that. Now the face of the cold hard truth, well, it looks like you. I've seen the face of the cold hard truth, and it looks like you. So, this is for the guy who wanted to hear Send in the Clowns. I've been a liar, I've been a liar. I've been the junkie, I've been the high. I've been a genius, I've been the fool. I've been the outlaw, I've been the rule. I've been the grifter, I've been the con. I've been the king and I've been the pawn. That's the life of a vagabond. I've been the freight train, I've been the jack. I've been the tightrope, I've been the slack. I've been the juggler, I've been scalpel, I've been the skin. I've been the headlights, I've been the deer. I've been the blindfold, I've been the mirror. And I never would have dreamed I'd end up here. On a steady course with an even keel, where you don't have to reinvent the wheel. Not if you got something real. I love the way that makes me feel. I love the way that makes me feel. But don't you understand? It's time to move on now. Let's make other plans. Kind of sounds kind of cowboy, you know? You better forget her as fast as you can. What part of all? Okay, maybe not. Don't you understand?
Yes, Schenectady.
They say you can't go back again. Here I am, just 100 miles to where I'm from. Now the wheels touch down, I'm safe and sound. I'd probably make it in before the dawn. Schenectady. Rolling past the golden blue, the old high school. Driving through the early morning mist. Coming to the hardware store where I worked before. Across the street from my first kiss. Home, this is home. They've been expecting me. Coming home, where they respected me, protected me, connected me. Schenectady. Mama's waiting in the drive as we arrive. Nothing I can do to dry her tears. Dressed up in my uniform on this gray morn. I finally made it back, but I'm not here. Home, this is home. They've been expecting me. Home, coming home, where they respected me, protected me, resurrected me. Now I'm gonna rest my bones in this field of stone and settle in, 'cause I've got time. Home at last, neath the leaves of grass, forever on the far side of the pine. Baby got a high IQ, big job, big paycheck too. She's a gourmet cook. Her vicious songs is off the hook. She plays the fiddle and the violin, depending on the kind of mood she's in. She can dance and sing. Hell, she can do anything. But still, a woman's got needs to call for a man like me. When it's time to kill a spider, take out the trash or change your tire. If there's a jar with the lid too tight, or strange noises downstairs in the middle of the night. If it's raining, I can walk the dog. And every time the toilet's clogged, I'm down on my knees. Thank God she needs me. True story. 'Cause she's the independent kind, a good woman of heart and mind, with a will so strong, it got her through the Boston Marathon. She's a pilot and an engineer. She's a fire department volunteer. Not a timid soul, And did I mention that she hablas Espanol? But I understand she still needs a man. When it's time to kill a spider, take out the trash or change a tire. There's a jar with a lid too tight, or strange noises downstairs in the middle of the night. If it's raining, I can walk the dog. And every time the toilets clog, I'm down on my knees. Thank God she needs me when she's feeling lonely, or for a little heart to heart. Or when she's in that special mood. Like when it's time to move the sofa, practice something that you learn on Oprah. Raking up a bag of leaves, or hauling off the Christmas tree. Spider tire, trash and jar, or just setting up the DVR. I'm down on my knees. Thank God she needs me. Thank God she needs me.
Thank you very much.
Rembrandt at a yard sale, or an oil well right out back. I'm not hanging up a horseshoe. There's no need to knock on wood. I don't even cross my fingers. I know none of these things will do me any good. 'Cause all my luck got all used up the day that I found you. Some people spend their whole lives jealous. All they can see is that half-empty glass. There's really no one I can envy. From up here on the greener grass. So why even spend a wheel of fortune? That winning number won't be mine. Every kind of superstition, even birthday wishing, it's just a waste of time. 'Cause all my luck got all used up the day that I found you. All my luck got all used up the day.
Thank you very much.